ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयम् उदीरयेत्। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः।
टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराणम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 3 टेक्स्ट 33।
जुवांग वै ब्रह्मणादिष्टो प्रजा सर्गे यदा ततः सन्यमेन्द्रिय ग्रामं तिपाथे परमं तप।
वर्ड मीनिंग जुबाम बोथ ऑफ यू कृष्णी एंड सुतापा बाई इंडिट ब्राह्मणा अधिष्टो अर्डर्ड बाई लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा हु इज नोन एज पितामह द फादर ऑफ द प्रजापतिस प्रजा सर्गे इन द क्रिएशन ऑफ प्रोजेनी जदा व्हेन ततः देयर आफ्टर संयम्य कीपिंग अंडर फुल कंट्रोल इंद्रिय ग्रामम The senses, tipathe, underwent, paramam, very great, tapaha, austerity. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki translation. When both of you were ordered by Lord Brahma to create progeny, you first underwent severe austerities by controlling your senses. Purport. Here is an instruction about how to use one's senses to create progeny. According to Vedic principles, before creating progeny, one must fully control the senses. This control takes place through the Garbhadhana Sanskar. In India, there is great agitation for birth control in various mechanical ways. But birth cannot be mechanically controlled. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Janma Mrityu Chara Vyadhi Dukha Dosanu Darsanam. Birth, death, old age and disease are certainly the primary distresses of the material world. People are trying to control birth, but they are not able to control death. And if one cannot control death, one cannot control birth either. In other words, artificially controlling birth is not any more feasible than artificially controlling death. According to Vedic civilization, procreation should not be contrary to religious principles, and then the birth rate will be controlled. as stated in Bhagavad Gita, dharma viruddha bhutesu kamasmi, sex not contrary to religious principles, is a representation of the Supreme Lord. People should be educated in how to give up birth, death, birth to good children. People should be educated in how to give birth to good children through sanskaras. Beginning with the garbhadana sanskara, birth should not be controlled by artificial means, for this will lead to a civilization of animals. If one follows religious principles, he automatically practices birth control. Because if one is spiritually educated, he knows that the after effects of sex are various types of misery, bahudukha bhaja. One who is spiritually advanced does not indulge in uncontrolled sex. Therefore, instead of being forced to refrain from sex or refrain from giving birth to many children, people should be spiritually educated and the birth control will automatically follow. If one is determined to make spiritual advancement, he will not beget a child unless able to make that child a devotee. As stated in Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.18, Pitana Sasyat, one should not become a father unless one is able to protect his child from mrityu, the path of birth and death. But where is their education about this? A responsible father never begets children like cats and ducks. Instead of being encouraged to adopt artificial means of birth control, people should be educated in Krishna consciousness, because only then will they understand their responsibility to their children. If one can beget children who will be devotees and taught to turn aside from the path of birth and death, mrityu sansara vartmani, there is no need of birth control. Rather, one should be encouraged to beget children. Artificial means of birth control have no value. Whether one begets children or does not, a population of men who are like cats and ducks will never make human society happy. It is therefore necessary for people to be educated spiritually, so that instead of begetting children like cats and ducks, they will undergo austerities to produce devotees. This will make their lives successful. Om Ajnanam Timiranthasya Jnanam Jana Salakaya Chakhir Unmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Svapadantikam Bande Aham Sri Guru Sri Juta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavansha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahaganam Raghunatham Nitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakha Nitamsa Namang Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Nitinamine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desa Tarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, in this chapter, where the birth of Lord Krishna is described, already Krishna has taken birth. in the jail room of Kamsa, where Vasudev Devaki were imprisoned. So now Krishna appeared in front of them in 400 form with full uniform and opulence. By seeing exactly Narayana form of Lord as their child, first Vasudev, both Vasudev and Devaki, they both became so much overwhelmed with joy because they got the child Sakya Sri Hari. And what kind of joy? By seeing the confirmation, by seeing the opulence and by seeing the characteristics of that child, fully with all uniform and all ornaments, first Vasudev, both of them, they became so much into the rasa, both mixed rasa, Aishwarya and Vatsalya. By seeing the Bhagavata, they are thinking he is Bhagavan. And by seeing as a child, they are thinking he is our child. So both parental and also rasa, Aishwarya rasa and Vatsalya rasa, both mixed together. So they started glorifying the Lord. First Vasudev, then Devaki. So first Vasudev glorified the glories and the opulence, and in between sometimes also in parental love, Vatsalya bhav, he was thinking, you are my child, I want to save you from the cruel hand of Kamsa. So I want to do something because you are my child, it is my duty as a father to save you. In the stuti, in middle also he was telling that. And after that, Devaki also continued in the same mood, glorifying this Supreme Lord. In his, about his swarupa, about his bhagavata, about his opulence, and mixed with same parental as a child, she was also expressing her views that you are sakhyat, looking all with opulence, Sri Hari, so, but now we know Kansa is so cruel, so we want to save you. So both mixed bhava they were telling, and for a long time, both Vasudev and Devaki, both they glorified the Lord appeared in front of them in 400 form. So after hearing their parents, their Vasudevs and Devaki's stuti, prarthana, Lord became really pleased. By their rasa, by their bhava, the Lord became pleased and Lord started answering to them, speaking to them. So around 14 verses spoken by Lord, started from 32, verse number 32 to 45 it will go on. So what Lord is speaking, because they are doubt, both the Vasudev Devaki, they have doubt. What will happen? He is 100% Lord. There is no doubt in it. But Kamsa will come and he is so cruel, he will kill him. So both way, they want to save him. Why you come in this form? Previously all the child, they come in normal form. Why you are coming in abnormal form? You should be normal, then you can do something. Because when the other child was not looking like Narayana, but Kamsa killed him, and you are looking 100%. There is no, nothing doubt. So Kamsa will definitely kill you. He has put us in jail. He has put all this arrangement for you only, to kill you only. So today is the final match. How can he? He will be very, very cruel, and he is coming. He is coming just to kill you. So why Vasudev and Devaki, they are astonishing and noting, why this child come with pants and with all his garments, with all his ayudha, with all his 400 form, everything in full form. So now Lord is going to answer his parents, what is the reason behind it, why he come in front of them, just in the beginning of the birth, in the 400 form, full form. What is the reason? So Lord started to telling both of them by giving the proper reason of his 400 form and opulence. He started telling their previous births. Actually, I come in full form, full uniform, because to confirm you, to make you assure that I am what you expect, what kams also expect, what everybody also expect. Devatas, Brahma, they prayed for, I am the same. To confirm, to make it sure. So that's I come with, otherwise who will recognize me? And then he's saying, why you are becoming so fearful and this that? We have relation, eternal relation. Many, many times I have taken birth as your son. It is not first time. Why you are doing thing like this? Many times I have taken birth as your son, and then he is giving the account that when in Swayambhu Manvantara, when my dear father Vasudev was Sutapa Prajapati, and you are Prishni, both of you, Prajapati and his wife, you, because son of Brahma, Lokapitamaha, the Prajapati Brahma, he ordered you to create progeny, to beget children. And you both, my father Sutapa Prajapati, he never disobeyed his father Brahma. He, with you, my dear mother, as Prushni at that time, you both decided, our father is telling us to create progeny. So then both of you decided, in the whole material society, if you see, people are after children, to getting a children. That's why the family life is centered around to get a good son, isn't it? Yes. If you analyze the family life, the real happiness lies in family life by getting a good son, for this only. And if they are not getting a good son, then finish. They will become so hopeless and harassed and so disheartened and unhappy. And the whole material society, they are after to get children, because we know that without getting a good children, without getting at least a son, then the Shraddha Kriya will finish, your dynasty will finish, and progeny will discontinue. So many things. So that's why for Dharma Rakhya, from Kula Rakhya, from this many point of views, and this is the only happiness in family life. So both husband and wife, they are always expecting a good child, and they are working on it. Many instances are there. Many couples, without getting a good son, they are doing putrashti jagya, these, they are many, many, many things. Many kind of tapasya, many kind of things they have to go through just to get a good son. And even if they get a good son, then who knows what kind of child he will be, whether black or white, other good or bad, fat or thinny, or educated or illiterate, and maybe obedient or disobedient. Maybe after some time he will pass away also, he will die. So then so many challenges and so many unhappiness, and this is happening in material life. Many times we see the boy, the son, they are taking so much trouble to take care of him, to educate him, to give him culture, to make him obedient, and he is going in the other way around. And the father and mother become really unhappy, really unhappy, for properly giving him education, to taking care of his health. If he becomes sick, then another unhappiness. If he become disobedient, then another unhappiness. And finally, if that son died, oh, forget. Then till their death, they can't forget this blow up unhappiness. They can't forget. So, if we consider, if we analyze the putra sukha by the parents, and the parents, by getting a child, whatever happiness they are getting, if you compare with unhappiness, unhappiness is more, much more. Yeah, yes, much more than that, if you really compare all the merits and demerits. So now Sutapa Prajapati and Krishna, they are thinking that what is the use of the whole material society is after this, to getting a immortal child, temporary child, for temporary happiness, what is the use? If our father Brahma is ordering us, then we should try something permanent. This is real pleasure, because we cannot deny putra sukha is tuchha, no? A very great happiness. But to get a good son and a permanent son, and we should take care, we should have our parental relation with him permanently, then only we can enjoy it. So how to get in this whole material world, it is not possible. If we can get son as the real immortal being, the Lord, then no question of, he will not become sick, he will not become uneducated, disobedient, and he will not pass away, he will not leave us, no? If somebody just achieve Lord, going to Lord, there is no question of coming back. Then how he will come and go back? So that is permanent arrangement. So in this, by thinking this, the both of them, they decide, so better if we are obeying our order of our father, so then we should try to get the Supreme Lord as our child. Then we will really enjoy the parental rasa, and the Brahma shadow will fulfill, everything will be okay. So now, to get Lord a child, no tapasya can bring him. Only one way, bhakti. Only by bhakti you can control him. That is the nature of Lord. He is controlled by bhakti. So they started tapasya, not the ordinary tapasya, tapasya of bhakti. Everything you want to do, everything you want to achieve, you have to go through some trouble, some difficulties. That is called tapasya. So to perform bhakti also, some voluntary difficulties we have to accept. That is called bhakti maya tapa. Bhakti maya tapasya. So they started doing severe austerities, not for the sake of austerities, but to perform proper devotion to get Supreme Lord as their child. So in the coming verses, we'll see what kind of severe austerities they go through. In this particular verse, particularly, Brahma ordered both of them, that Lord is saying, you both are ordered by our Pitamaha Brahma, Prajapati, and Prajasarge Yadatataha, and you started controlling your senses seriously. Tapathe paramang tapa, and severe austerities, you underwent severe austerities. Definitely you can understand this austerity is not ordinary austerity. This austerity is aiming mixed with devotion, pure devotion. So, Prabhupada, in the fully purport, is starting with, see, if anybody, any place, any time, they want to have a good child, then first requirement is they have to control their senses. Without controlling senses, forget to get a good child. No, it is not possible. In the beginning, that's what in Bhagavatam we are understanding. When Brahma ordered the Prajapati, Sutapa, and Krishna, then they, both of them, voluntarily agreed to go through severe austerities. That is the process to get a good child. Yes. Even after getting married, then both of husband and wife has to go through proper austerities, proper sanskar to get a good child. Otherwise they have to cry whole life. Yeah. So that's what we are getting the lesson, that controlling senses is very much required for everything. Even for getting a good child, we have to control senses. Yes. So that is the Vedic principles. Before creating progeny, one must fully control the senses. And in Vedic culture, we see the sanskara starts with Garbhodhana sanskara. Garbhodhana sanskara. when the both husband and wife they will meet, at that time they have to go through some purificatory process. It's called Garbhadhana Sanskar. So Prabhupada is pointing out the today's situation, and today's we have advanced technically so much, scientifically, and many ways we had advanced. And Prabhupada saying the whole, especially in India, in the whole world there is, especially in India, because population is increasing anything, there is great agitation to control the birth. Janma Niyantrana. Everybody knows Janma Niyantrana. And how to niyantrana, how to control the birth? Janma, they are applying some technical means, some technical process, artificial process, that you should not have a child. Some artificial means they are accepting. So Prabhupada is criticizing this. Well, in this way, you cannot control, because this cannot be controlled. This is not your hand. Because this, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna told, Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadhi, they are the symptoms of this material world. Tukha, Dosa, Anudarsanam. Who are you to control it? It's controlled by the Supreme Lord, Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadhi. You cut in this way, stop in this way, the other way it will come. So, you cannot control the Janma, or if you somehow or other by applying, by using artificial means, or by killing the embryo, killing the child, you control the birth, but you cannot control the death. What technical means you have to control the death? All the modern achievements are failure in front of death. Now, in this passing year 2020, all of us have good experience that even a insect which we cannot see, a virus, unseen virus, can change the consciousness of the situation of the whole world. Superly advanced countries, they are fully confused just by a virus which we can see even. If unseen such a insignificant, such a small virus can create so much fear in the whole world, all down from doctors, scientists, all big, everybody is fearful, and so fear for months together, for 6, 7, 8 months they are locked down inside the room. For what? For such a small insect which you can see even. And if he big one, then forget what will happen. So, it's a very good challenge to for the whole modern civilization and to for everybody, all of us. So we are so much fearful. So how we can control something? So just by accepting some material means, some technical, artificial way, we cannot control the birth. So the real way to control birth and to get good children is by educating ourselves, educating the society, educating the human beings about the spiritual values, about Krishna consciousness. Then automatically they will feel it and they will try to control their senses and try to beget a good child. But nowadays they are begetting child like cats and dogs. The good population is the basic principles of a society to achieve peace, prosperity and spiritual growth. If you want to have spiritual growth, peace and happiness, then it is essential to have a good population, good progeny. Without good man, forget it. You cannot create a good civilization through cats and dogs. Forget it. Never. So nowadays, most of our children are nothing better than cats and dogs. But I am not saying like that. If you consider, compare the nature, and because in the society is moving this way. They are forgetting the culture, they are forgetting the spiritual values, the values of the life, just gratifying their senses, to gratify their senses, they are begetting child. And what they will be? Animalistic. They are becoming animal. And you cannot expect peace and prosperity from animal. No, their nature is different. So human being should first to be taught what means the human being. What is human? To first to become a human, then behave like a human being. We don't know. We have no knowledge of a good human. We have no knowledge. So that's why in the Vedic civilization is very much giving stress on educating people regarding this for the good society. Varnasrama dharma, all these things are there. The whole system of dharma, actually the whole dharma is after this only. Dharma, in the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita, in first chapter Arjun speak in front of Krishna, Krishna, if dharma abhivavat Krishna, pradyusanti kula striya, lupta pindodaka kriya, all these things will happen, the hellish situation will happen if you get unwanted progeny. Varna Sankara will, yes, if the womans will be polluted by following the irreligious things, then the whole society become hellish. In the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was thinking like that. And Krishna approved, yes, this is fact. So, that's why our religious system, the whole dharma sanskar, is very much stressing this point, how to get a good culture, how to, unless you properly trained in Krishna consciousness, there is no impetus for controlling senses. Why? If you tell you, please do, get up early morning, follow this, why? For what? Why will you go through this? I'm taking aram, I'm taking pleasure. So, because you don't know the value of it. So first of all, it's our duty to educate the whole society regarding the values of life, culture of. So then they will be ready to control their senses. Sa niyamya indriya gramam prajasak. Without controlling their senses, if they want to beget child and control through artificial means, forget, then they will get only cats and dogs. And then what you expect from them? No expectation. So if everybody will become devotee and will understand the values of life, real goal of life, then automatically they will follow the sense control, niyama indriya grama. It is said in Bhagavatam that a person should not become a father unless he is able to take care of the child and to help the child to get free from birth and death. Pitana sasyat. Guru says many things are saying in Bhagavatam. The responsibility, matana sasyat also. One should not become a father, neither mother, neither father, nor guru, nor devata, unless they should understand their responsibilities. So now the society is full of irresponsible parents. So we cannot just blame the children. It is our duty. It is the duty of parents. Duty of father is there, duty of mother is there. There. Of course, the responsibilities of the children is there. But we cannot just blame fully to him. He became like this. No, he not became. You are also part of it. So that's why Brahma, when he ordered Prushni and Sutapa to Prajauttamnam, to please create progeny, so first of all, without meeting themselves, oh, now we ordered, got sanctioned, become happy. No, they immediate go through, underwent severe austerities. So how much that is required? So, by this we can understand the whole human being should follow this principle. Follow this principle. If somebody wants to have a good son, then first of all they have to go through the sanskaras, go through the indriya sanjama. This is very much required. Actually, I think all of you know this, today is big crowd here due to New Year. isn't it? Many of you are in the same mood. Though we are following, according to Vedic culture in India, the new year starts in Gaurabdhan, Gaur Purnima, and start from there only. That is our Vedic calendar. But the whole world is following the Western calendar. We are also, all our school, colleges, office, in our temple calendar, you see, December, we are selling the calendar. So we cannot just say like that. No, no. Everything is inside and outside society, everywhere, following the Western religion. So today is New Year, we have to accept. Just we cannot say like that. So, okay, today is the first day of the New Year 2021. Yesterday, many people, they stay up to late night to get goodbye to the sad year of 2020. And they have good expectation of a good new year of 2021, today morning. Whole night they can't sleep, and somehow or other get up early to come to Mangala Arati to, oh, the whole year will be Mangala. Arey Baba, when 2019 passed away, 2020 comes, same thing you have done. So what happened? Even if you come to Mangala Arati in the 1st January of 2020, the whole 2020 passed away like this. So don't expect that come the first January of 2021, then you will expect something. No. So the proper understanding is this new year of having 2021 is not a change of year, it's not a change of time. In this change of year, we should prepare to change ourselves. We should take a decision the first day of the year in front of Radha Sam Sundar Krishna Balaram Gaur Nitai. We should take a vow to change our consciousness. It is not just the change of year. It is a change of consciousness. It depends upon us individually. What to change? What to change? This change of consciousness, starting that all of us to ready to change, we should first start. We have this fearing so much. The whole year 2020 we are fearful. So we have to change from our consciousness, from fear to faith. We should change our fear to be faithful. Fear to faith. And then, why you are fearing? You are blaming because of this, because of this, because of that. So we have to change our mood of blaming others to, without blaming others, we should feel responsibility. We should feel responsible. Yes, I am also part of it. Always I am telling you, his son is bad, you are chastising, beating him. Don't blame him. Accept your responsibilities too. So this kind of change is required when you becoming something new, rejuvenate yourself. So we should change our consciousness from blaming others to accepting responsibilities. Then, in this fearful and blaming, we are fully irritated. The whole world's irritation so much, how much I am taking all this in the greatest drink of 2020 is kadha. Everybody, whole world, they are drinking kadha and taking steam. This was the, so from irritation to patience. We should change. It's not the change of year. We should change our irritating mood to be patient. And in this mood, all of us are very much angry many times. So we should change our consciousness from anger to acceptation. And all these young boys, they are always, not only this year, whatever, any time they are fully in competitive mood. So in till you are in this mood, forget. So we have to change our consciousness from competition to cooperation. If you can do that, you have to change our consciousness from competitive consciousness to cooperative consciousness. have to cooperate with each other. And also, we have to change our consciousness from expectations from acceptance. Forget our expectation. Whatever situation is there, Hari Ichha, accept it. Then we'll become happy. We have no authority to change anything. We cannot. So why you are expecting so much and by expectation becoming unhappy? So forget expectation. Just accept whatever is there. No matter whatever, just accept it. And then forget the mood of comparison and try to be content. So this changing of year is not the changing of year only. If you enjoy the new year, then all of us should be ready to change our thinking, feeling and understanding and our consciousness too. Then you can enjoy the real new year. And that can be possible if you take a vow in the first day in the darshan of Lord that, okay, in this new year, I am taking this vow, I want to do this change. Now, goodbye to the 2020. Now 2021 is coming. At least in this 2021, if I can do these changes to some extent in me, then if I change, then others will change. The world can change. This expectation is good expectation. So by accepting whatever the situation in the society, if we just change our thinking, if all of us will start changing ourselves in our thinking, then others will also follow it, and definitely we will get a very good peace atmosphere. Then you can enjoy the new year mood in the new consciousness. So here in this particular verse, it's spoken by Lord Himself. The Lord is speaking to His parents in front of them, and He's telling, oh my dear mother, you are not ordinary. You are not just an ordinary mother, or my father, you are not such an ordinary father. Why? No, because you are my dear mother and father many, many times. To become a father of the Supreme Lord is not ordinary, not even extraordinary. Much more than extraordinary even. So why you are becoming fearful? Why you are thinking so much? You know that why Kansa is putting into jail? Why Kansa put him into jail? Why Kansa arranged all the securities? Why he is killing all my elder brothers? You know that? No, yes, because he is fearful. For what he is fearful? No, because he will kill him. When he heard the announcement that the eighth child will kill him, immediately from that point he became so much fearful and he is taking so many measures. He put you in jail and he this, that, he is doing so many things because of this only. Because of whom? Because of me only. I am the eighth child. My dear parents, I am your eighth son. For which reason, for what? Kansa is totally in stress and doing all these things because of thinking of me only. And if it is announced 8 years before by Devas that I am going to kill him, and by hearing this, Mama Kansa is high sugar and high BP and everything like that, and is doing all these illegal things. And if it is decided in before that I am the killer of Kansa, then why you are becoming fearful that Kansa will kill me? You didn't hear this announcement? No, yes, I heard this, and Kansa is doing all these things because of this fear only, that he will be killed. Now Kansa knows, you knows, all the prajas knows, demigods knows, then why you become fearful? If everybody knows that the eighth child is going to kill Kansa, it is sure. Everybody knows. So why you are fearful? Now yes, all of us, Kansa knows and we also knows. We also know, Kansa also knows that you are going to kill him, you are the eighth child. And that's why he's taking all these measures. But you are a small child, Baba. And we know Kansa is so strong, so powerful, so cruel. So how becoming your father and mother, like all your elder brothers are killed by him so cruelly, and you are so attracted, you are so nice, and he will also kill you. We can't take it, we can't tolerate it. And Lord is telling, that's why I come in an extraordinary way. All other elder brothers of mine, they have not come with pant and shirt, all of their uniform dress and ornaments like that. I came in a totally different way, extraordinary, because to convince that don't worry now, Kamsa is gone, don't worry, now all miseries are finished. To make sure, that's why I come in this dress, and now become again fearful. What to do? Then Lord thought, it is not good, they are my parents, so they are expecting me to do some service for me, to save to me, to do something. So that is their first desire and first expectation from me. So as a good son, I should not be disobedient. This will create a record again. The first son, as Supreme Lord, he also didn't fulfill the desire of their mother and father. So okay, if you want me to become a normal child, I'm becoming a normal child and telling you. Now they don't know. You are also incredible. So how you can save me? Now you also tell us. We want to save you. What is the way? You tell. So Krishna also, the Lord also tell him, do this way, then save me. So that's why the Lord is telling all these verses, and he will give the history of their previous births and convince them to make them free from fear. So anyway, so again and again, I also pray to their lordship and expect to have some change in me and my consciousness, and pray to all of you that all of you who are hearing, they should also pray and try their best to change their thinking and consciousness. Then you can have a good new year 2021. Hare Krishna. Yes, any comments or question? Yes.
Hare Krishna Maharaji, thank you for the results. In this present age, it's difficult to expect from outside agencies to provide such kind of training where people go through austerities and learn the lessons of life as per a Vedic civilization. Then there are institutes like our ISKCON, but there are very few who are teaching such values. But then, to whom it is taught, to me, members, they generate this mood of renunciation, and then they continue to remain like this. So where is the transformation from them to grihasthas, and where the training is given to females also? So is it wrong that in this present age we can expect a society where children have been produced with such mood?
Good. You have it's a good question. But see, this is all these things happening due to our ignorance. We are not educated enough about the culture, about the sanskaras, about we don't have that much you can say impetus to do sense control, to do tapasya. So that needs proper education. That's why we have to read the scriptures and help others to read the scriptures. That's a proper stage and book distribution. He has written these things in the books. If all educated people, they will read this and understand this, and we should help this, help others also to read and understand this, then they will feel the urgency how to change themselves and how to control their senses and create good progeny, and expect, then you can expect a good society, good children, everything. Unless we change ourselves, we means we person, each individual has to take a decision and try to change him. All men and women, everybody is their responsibility. If everybody feel their responsibilities and feel responsible for whatever happening in the society, not to blame others, we should feel that I am also responsible for that. I have my part to perform. If all of us will responsibly execute our part of duties, then only you can expect. Otherwise, how can we expect? Even you are asking, you have some responsibility to execute too. You first do your parts, then you can expect others. Without doing ourselves, how can we expect and you do now? How can they first you do, Baba? Then others. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told us, Bharat Bhumite Janma Manushya Janma Hailadar Janma Sarthaka Kari Kara Paropakar. First you try to understand it, practice it, follow it, and make your life success, then help other life to be success. Isn't it? First, unless we convinced ourselves individually, how we can expect others? How can I expect our child? Is that okay? Yes. He is Mr. Question. Yes, good. Actually, when somebody is coming to temple for darshan, actually his body is coming. His activity is not coming. His mind is not coming. Mind is somewhere else. And only, somebody was telling me, when you are coming, your charan is bringing you, your acharan is not bringing you. When your acharan, when your action brings you to the Lord and shows you, gave darshan to the Lord, then that is proper darshan. Not just walk to temple and the same polluted consciousness, what will happen? That's why our society's name is Krishna consciousness. Not just Krishna crowd. It's a good crowd of Krishna. No. The crowd should be Krishna conscious crowd. So, unless our body is coming, mind is somewhere else. Mind is engaged in something else. So when mind is coming to temple, then your body and your wealth, everything will follow it. So, okay, in New Year, Mangal Darshan, it should come. But that's what I told, you should change your consciousness into pure, perfect consciousness. You have a darshan and take a decision, take a vow, then some effect is there. Otherwise, just, I went Bangladesh. Hey, I have been, 4:30, I was there 4:30 in such a chilled weather. To just get some name and fame and credit and adoration, what is the use of that? Useless. Okay? Yes. Yes.
Hare Krishna. Just like Sudarbha and Rishi perform austerities and they control their senses. So, right now, how we can control our senses?
It's a very simple thing. It is prescribed in Shastra. If you don't know, ask your authority, spiritual authority. They will tell you. But in this Kali Yuga, you don't do what Prushni and Sutapa did, eating dry leaves and other. You take nice only prasadam, not outside chaat and panipuri. You take prasadam offered to Krishna, and every day get up early morning, come for Mangala Arati, do the full morning program and attend service, and that's your austerity. Very simple austerity. Then see how you are getting changed. This is so simple, and we can do it. It is not something very difficult. If you are not doing that, then how we can expect the other austerity, go to Himalaya or do this, forget. This is not for Kali Yuga people. They are in Satya Yuga, they can do that. They are millions of lifespan. We have a very simple temporary life of 40, 50, 60, 80 years. In the young age, you are feeling old age. So what austerities you are expecting? This is perfect austerity for us to follow the rules and regulations of ISKCON, Krishna Conscious Society, and be Krishna Conscious. That is perfect austerity for this age. Okay? Yes?
Sir, how to maintain Krishna Consciousness? Sir, as a student, how to maintain Krishna Consciousness and studies together?
How to maintain Krishna Consciousness?
And studies.
Okay, good, you are a student, I mean. Okay, huh? So how to maintain Krishna consciousness and studies? You can become a Krishna conscious student. When you are studying or doing anything, a worker can be a Krishna conscious worker. A warrior can be a Krishna conscious warrior. A student can be a Krishna conscious student. A scientist can be a Krishna conscious scientist. A doctor can be a Krishna conscious doctor. A preacher can be a Krishna conscious. Everything we do, your profession, you just linked into Krishna and become Krishna conscious, okay?
And how to become Krishna conscious student?
That's why you become Krishna conscious student means whatever you are studying, whatever you are doing, that your goal should be to please Krishna. If you please Krishna, then you should, your study method should be changed. You should get up early in morning before Brahma Arati and come to temple in front of Lord. Lord, please bless me, I should be a good student in a proper mood. Pray to Lord and then go and chant some rounds, then start reading. In the Krishna conscious students, they will not study in the whole night like Bhut Preth. That is a Preth Bhutas standard. Nowadays all the students, whole night they will study and the day sleep. No. This is Mahatamaguna. Study in Brahma Muhurta. The time is very helpful. And then sleep early. There is a notion in English also. Early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. You want to be like that? Healthy, wealthy and wise? So what is the formula? Very simple. Just sleep early and wake up early. So that is Krishna conscious. First starting from this. Then come to Lord, pray to Lord, do some chanting, read some Bhagavad Gita, a page or two pages a day, and do your studies, then see. And eat only Krishna prasadam, don't do garbage. So that is it. You can become a Krishna conscious student. I am not saying you forget your studies. No, no, no. Do your studies. Do your job what you are doing. Just change your attitude that everything what you are doing, I am really servant of Krishna, I should please Krishna in this way. In these activities, through these activities, our aim is to please Krishna. So, dovetail your actions in Krishna. That's it.
Sir, I have another question.
Okay, yes.
My question is that in home, our family members are not devotee and they also don't...
Baba, okay, I understand. Your family members, if you get up 3:30, 4 o'clock, family members, they will wake up at 7:30, 8 o'clock. Your Krishna conscious activity is finished by that time. So who is stopping you? It is you. If you sleep early by 8 o'clock, you sleep and get up by 3 and do your chanting and start studying, then who is stopping you? Why you are blaming the family members? Don't blame others.
No, sir, my question is that actually I can't attend Mangala Arati especially in home.
Okay, no need to come to temple, Baba. No need to create a temple. If you are a student staying in your family, just try to sleep early and wake up early. And then by getting up, even if you don't want to take a cold bath, forget to take bath. wash your face and chant few rounds, 5-6 rounds, then start studying. That's also a good start of becoming a Krishna conscious student. Okay?
And what prasadam
we... Whatever prasadam your family is giving, just make sure that non-veg should not be there. It should be vegetable, and if they are not offering, you offer your mentally. Oh Krishna, I am a student in staying in a hostel and family, so please be merciful in me, accept just something like that. I should want to take prasad. Pray like that and eat. Okay?
Thank you, Maharaj.
ओके हरे कृष्णा ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण की समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय।